Hello everyone, and let's talk about the latest disappointment in Star Wars. Should I say disappointment? I mean developer livestream, sorry about that. In Star Wars The Old Republic, this one was as disappointing as all the rest have been. So, it's consistency. They've got a good consistency with their developer livestreams. They're each shit and very disappointing, okay? Set the bar low. Because, when you're going into these, set the bar low, and they still fail to hit that bar as well. With the developer live stream, we're just going to sum it up. I didn't watch it live. I went and watched it after I did my live stream. People were talking about it. And what are we getting? Well, they said group content. They not going to do anything, basically. Until the cinematic story press the one key for victory things is over. Which is Knights of the Fallen Empire, basically. So just sit there, spam your strike or your hammer shot or whatever the hell your basic attack is, and you'll get through Knights of the Fallen Empire. Hell, just go AFK and let your companion do it. You know, your companion's got better, they're better stats than you anyway, so, why not? The GTN search will be fixed, apparently. They need live server info to fix this bug. It doesn't fucking work. Right, fucking fix it. Why? Here's a tip for you. Go on the live servers and take a fucking look at it. Why am I paying to fix your bugs or paying to identify your bugs? Go ID them yourself. You get paid to do this. You're professional in inverted commas. Developers, might as well put developers in inverted commas as well. We might as well make one quotation set. Professional developers, you're supposed to be. Get this thing fixed. This is one of these bugs that really pisses me off, okay? That and the respec bug, they went on far, far too long. I'd rather they took the servers off and fixed them. You know, that's one of those bugs where I don't want to fucking play the game. Piss me off so much, those bugs. They said they had issues with the events, so they're running them in January. Awesome. Nothing like that holiday feeling. Should we run Christmas again in January as well? Should we take days off for the holidays again in January? Again, another huge fuck up by them as well, which they didn't even offer us compensation for them. Where's our compensation? You know, can we get some freebies maybe? You know, something to say, hey, we're the developers and we care? No. Didn't even get an apology as well. Did we get an apology? I don't remember hearing it, to be honest. To be honest, I did fall asleep halfway through it. It took me two sittings to watch it. It's only about, what is it, half an hour long? I can't remember how long it was, but it took me two sittings to watch it. All right, I had to, I was like, oh, I'm gonna do something else. This is boring as hell. Guild Conquest rewards are coming. Who cares about Conquest? They're doing feedback into the cartel market. Keep the gold packs, really, and give me Revan Reborn's armor. I sunk 20k cartel coins into those gold armor packs. I still don't have Revan Reborn's armor. I mean, yeah, I made 10 million credits on selling the armors on the GTN, but it's 29 million credits on the Red Eclipse for Revan Reborn's armor. So, it's still a way short of that, so I'm probably gonna have to spend more. Maybe I should just sell the gold packs on the GTN. If the search worked, then, that would be nice. But I have sold some of the armorings, made about 10 mil off of them. They're better than the hyper crates, at least, because you're going to get a good piece of armor, at least, or at least something that's remotely desirable. They don't have anything to share right now about new events that they're going to add. Well, making the events you've got work should be a priority, really. New chapter will come every 4 weeks. I'll believe that when I see it. We'll take a look at that further down when they start explaining chapter 10, or the 4.1 is getting less and less content every time. Okay, we'll talk about that as well. The new chapters every 4 weeks. Do they plan to add any new events? They've said they're getting good mileage out of the current events. To be honest, they're running out fast of mileage. There's no reason for me to do the Gree event now, to see no point in it. There's also no real, ever since I got my infected Varactyl mount, I've no reason to go back to the Rat Ghoul event, and the Bounty Hunter event lost lost interest in that a long, long time ago, so I've no real reason to ever go back to any of their current events. Would like to see the Chevin event though. The Chevin event was a cool event. They put all the mounts and weapons and things back in the game with 4.0. Give us the Chevin event. I still have tokens of enrichment on three characters from that event back in the day, so I would like to see that again. That's not one that's been run into the ground. Right, let's get to it. The delays, 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 delays. Eternal Championship, which was meant to be a big part of Chapter 10, is coming with Chapter 11 instead of Chapter 10. There you go. And Bodar is also coming with Chapter 11. He is going to be linked to the Eternal Championship event. So if you want your Wookiee, then you're going to have to wait to stroke your Wookiee, Unless you're a smuggler and you can, summon him back and then, have fun as a smuggler. But yeah, Chapter 10 is coming out February 11th. It's going to be starring Kaleo, who's called Firebrand. Maybe Bodar is called Stormcaller, What I want to know is anyone going to be called Kephis in the later chapters? Because if we're just going to use bosses from EC, as characters from everything else, is Blitz going to be called Blitz can be called Stormcaller, Bodar can be Zorn maybe, and maybe we'll get, I don't know, someone else can be called Toth. And their naming conventions are pretty shit. Why have you called her Firebrand? It's like, come on, that was one of your bosses. And it's like, you can't even be bothered cycling through the name generator for a random name. I mean, at least they changed Scorpio to the Lady of Sorrows, I suppose. This is spoilers, by the way, but most people will have done Knights of the Fallen Empire. If you haven't done Knights of the Fallen Empire, why the fuck are you watching this video, really, to be honest with you? To be honest, why are you watching it? We know it's Kaleo. We've seen that when we finished Chapter 9. Okay, it's going to be coming February 11th. You're going to recruit Kaleo. You're going to be able to recruit Blitz. It's going to be a mission. He's gonna have an all new Jawa crew on Hoth. Jawas! I want an army of Jawas. An army of Jawas is what we need. Okay. Maybe even kill some Jawas. Maybe Jawa gang wars, like GTA with Jawas. Imagine that. Imagine Grand Theft Auto. Jawas. Oh, now you're interested. That ride Banthas. Gotta be in the game. Okay, that's good. Place the vehicles. With ba Oh, what is it? The big sand crawlers. Sand people rode Banthas, wasn't it? Yeah, sand people rode Banthas. Jawas versus sand people. That needs to be a mode in Star Wars Battlefront. Come on, DICE. Put that in Battlefront. They could go about with their big sand crawler and they could run about with their Banthas. The sand people have their Banthas and the Jawas on their big sand crawler. That'd be awesome! Jawas versus sand people. Make it happen. Someone make it happen. Someone at EA. Hello, is that EA? Yeah, I got a money winning idea. I'm gonna call EA when I finish this and pitch that to them. I'm gonna pitch that. Jawas versus sand people. I was gonna say Jawas versus Banthas, but yeah, that could work as well. Jawas versus sand people. It needs to happen. Either Battlefront or SWTOR. Be a good PvP mode. Good idea for the new Warzone, maybe. Maybe that'll be in the new Warzone. I doubt it very much, but you're gonna make decisions and make consequences. One part of the consequence can be seen at the end of the chapter, another part is further down the road. So there's gonna be consequences, like, I don't know, maybe we'll get to pick red, yellow, what was it, red, green, blue, or whatever in Mass Effect 3. Maybe we'll get to pick a different color for the ending. Don't know, really, but the choice and consequences so far haven't been great so far. Although that is Chapter 10. What else have we got? Blitz and his Jawa crew. I like the look of that. I like the look of that. It looks cool. The crafting update. Skill increases to 550. Isn't it already 550? I don't know. There's new craftable gear and mods. It's going to be eye level 208. Item rating 208, should we say. Really? Do we need 208? Does anybody still want 208 gear right now? When we have a flooded with what is it, glowing and radiant data crystals right now, and we can just buy commendation gear, or we're flooded with Mark II 216 and Mark II 220 gear, right now, if you're a raider, you're going to be flooded with that crap. And also, you know, most people can craft 216, 220. Most people don't even bother with 216. It's a waste of time. Very few crafters bother crafting 216 relics. They're a waste of time. Nobody wants them. Get the 220 ones. And there's plenty of dark matter catalysts floating around. You know, I've got tons of them. Plenty of the blue material as well. So, you know, do we really care? Really? Effects, like augment, mark levels as well, they're all going to be bumped up. So we're going to have to be 550 to craft mark 8 augments. I don't know, I mean, does it really affect us? There's old stuff is coming back, like war hero shells and things like that. That's good. The war hero stuff was pretty nice. I like the war hero stuff. Hopefully, maybe bring back some Kalumi and Tyanese gear while you're at it as well. That gear looked really cool. And also have the drop rates for them. Put them into the thing as well. Maybe put them into the boxes that you get. Maybe not the actual armorings, the shell, but the schematic for them. Maybe put them into that. And it might give us a reason to grind heroics again. There you go. They've talked about class balance changes. They said they're debating if they should do small changes every month like they did last year, or do big sweeping changes every few months. So, well, you've got a choice. Do you want to ruin the game every month, or do you want to ruin the game every few months, essentially? Because that's what class balance in this game means. Personally, I'd like them to do as little changes as possible to the classes, because when they say changes, change in Bioware speak is make worse, okay? Everything they do, they just make things worse. So no, do class balance changes as little as possible, okay? Just leave it alone, okay? You've never once, well, not for a long time, I've ever seen a class change, at least since 3.0 at least, have we ever seen a class change, class balance change patch that's been good for classes. I mean, they nerfed all the damage classes practically in the last patch. So no, don't do it. You're very, very bad at this. You're not skilled at this, okay? You are not skilled at this, okay? Please do not do class balance changes. Do twice a year. I'm fine, twice a year. That's fine. Every 6 months, don't touch them. Leave them alone, okay? We'll move on to the new PvP, which is the new war zone, should we say, which will be King of the Hill. Oh, yes. Oh, my big dick guardian's big dick just got bigger, I think. Surely King of the Hill was made for tanks, okay? You want to be a tank in King of the Hill. Survive, take the hill, survive as long as you can in the hill. Big dick guardians is what you want in there. You want a big dick guardian in that, defending that hill. No vigilant thrusting nonsense. No, a big dick defense guardian, you know, defending that hill, increasing their health. Ensure is going to get a good one. What's the other one? Focus defense. Awesome. Also, the other two tanks probably do well as well, but yeah, you want to be a big dick guardian. It's going to be multiple hills that spawn random. Oh, there's going to be multiple hills, okay? Get multiple big dick guardians to take and defend that. Well, you'll need other classes to take the hill, but your big dick guardian's going to defend it with his big dick sticking out. Defending that hill, not vigilantly thrusting, because he's not a DPS guardian. But yeah, so the release date will be revealed in February. There's another live stream in February. It's going to be within 6 months, so summertime would be good, you know, sort of June-July time would be quite nice for a new PvP mode. Better go get my Guardian and get him some gear, get him some tank gear, and we want to be defending them hills, okay? Probably suck, probably get one-shotted by a fucking Sage Healer. Sage Healers, then, I guess, will be the kings of the hill, I guess. Rather than the big dick guardian. I suppose they will be, you know, knowing the way the game balance has gone. Maybe they'll change the game balance. They're never going to nerf sages. So the Eternal Championship, which is being delayed, that they have said, it's designed to be a solo challenge to test player skills. It's meant to be the transition point from solo content to group content. Yeah, you're about fucking 2 years too late with that. Well done. Far too late. Too little too late. To be honest, the horse is bolted, okay? It's long gone, okay? There's going to be 10 encounters, okay? The first 5 are going to be easy, allowing for a broad group of players to get through. The last 5 encounters will be harder. You can do this solo or in a group, so the last 5 are going to be pretty hard. There's 3 weekly missions, one for finishing the first 5, one for finishing 7, and one for finishing 10. They are looking for feedback, though, on the rewards, which I will do as a separate video, the feedback for the rewards. Personally, I have, you know, interesting. It depends on how difficult they are, you know. It depends on the equivalent. Is Wave 10 going to be HM Revan? Or is it going to be solo mode Revan? Depends, you know. Is it going to be like that, you know? Or story mode Revan? Story mode Revan would probably be where it's right. We'll use Revan. We'll measure everything in Revans, shall we? Got nothing else to do with Revan. So you got solo mode Revan, which is piss easy. Story mode Ops. Revan, which is, you know, not too bad. And you've got HM Revan, which is the hardest, one of the hardest, that's it, the hardest boss in the game, HM Revan, at the moment. So, you know, there is, I'd say that, have that as your barometer. Measure our difficulty in Revans. That's how we're gonna measure our difficulty. Because there's 3 of them, and, you know, 3 difficulties. So, on a scale of 1, on a scale of Revan's difficulty, how difficult is it going to be? That is the question, okay? So there's going to be rare drops in the encounters, there's going to be weekly mission rewards, it'll probably give you a crap, probably get you a box thing. You also have to recruit Bodar, so it's obviously you're going to get things to recruit him, trophies we'll call them, I guess. So the harder encounters you get them faster, okay? So they are looking for feedback on the rewards, but we'll do that in a separate video. So anyway, that is all for this video. Another underwhelming live stream. At least the Eternal Championship looks interesting, I suppose, and it is good to get a new war zone. So we did end on a positive note. Everything else, don't do class balance changes and, you know, crafting, who cares? Getting the Jawa crew is good, I guess. Chapter 10 seems to have very little content, though. 4.1 is going to have very little content. Chapter 11 seems to hopefully have a bit more content anyway. Still no word on a new operation or new flashpoints. They're not talking about it right now. But, you know, they're talking about Firebrand. You know, probably rename Coratini will probably show up as another. Oh, get Coratini in the game. Get her armor in the game. On the cartel market, because I want it. But anyway, that is all for this video, so thank you for joining me, and we'll see you again soon, and goodbye.